It's the national finals of Great British Menu. This week, the eight regional champions are going head-to-head.
We need to be hitting those tens, though.
For a chance to cook at the glorious banquet marking 100 years of the Women's Institute. The chefs must honour the custodians of impeccable home cooking, and only flawless dishes can make the grade.
I want to make sure that this is absolute perfection.
And this year, the judges' shortlist for each dish no longer has three guaranteed places.
Maybe just two of you will make the grade. And if only one dish is perfect, we will just choose a winner.
Yesterday's starter was a triumph for Richard Bainbridge.
Come here. You know.
After four attempts at the competition, he's finally in with a chance. His competitor for the banquet starter is Southwest's Josh Eggleton, who was shocked to find his dish on the shortlist.
Your great granny Eggleton would have been so proud of you.
Yeah, I think she would. Yeah.
Today is the battle for the fish course.
I got two tens in the chamber for this one. Give it all that.
Judges Matthew Fort, Prue Leith, and Oliver Payton have their standards set to high.
It is such precise cooking. Every one of those tiny things is perfect.
They're joined in their quest for immaculate food by a president of the WI, Kirsty Bowen.
WI is all about high standards, so let's just hope that your dishes really meet that perfection.
I don't really like it. I'd probably give it a 5.
Oof, that is harsh.
I'm sorry.
With only three courses left to make the shortlist, some chefs must fall.
I'm not 100% happy, so I'm not serving it.
I think there might be tears.
Whilst others will shine.
Just watching something original and different and amazing.
He's literally a genius.
Never seen anything like it. I don't know what to say.
As only the finest dishes can reach the banquet.
We debated long and hard and decided that...
Competing this week are newcomers Michael O'Hare from the Northeast, who finished in last place with his starter, and Adam Bannister representing Wales, who also failed to impress the judges.
Morning. I'm confident going into fish.
It may not be my strongest dish, but you know, I believe in it. What about yourself?
Yeah, I did well with it in regionals, so as confident as you can be in this competition.
The judges, as ever, are looking for a fish course worthy of the banquet.
Rich and Josh. Well, it was a testing old day yesterday, but we ended up with two cracking starters.
But today we have a shoal of great fish dishes to choose from.
Next in, Michelin-starred Matt Gillen, representing London and the South East, and newcomers Ben Arnold from Northern Ireland and the North West's Matt Warswick.
Morning.
Morning.
They're up against last year's Scottish champion Jack O'Donnell, who just missed out on a starter shortlist place.
I'm really interested in Jack, whose fish course is really, really good, so she'll be trying really hard.
How are you feeling after yesterday?
I'm feeling pretty good, actually.
I was totally surprised that you weren't up there. It was a really top cracking dish.
It just shows you how flawless these dishes have to be.
Their skill at cooking fish, I think we take that for granted. It's the way they can tailor that dish for the banquet.
It is really about perfection.
Finally, the only two chefs to make the banquet shortlist, Southwest's Josh Eggleton and Central Region's Richard Bainbridge.
Hello, y'all.
Here we go, we got the big guns.
Still can't believe I'm on the shortlist.
You must be on cloud nine as well, Rich.
Yeah, no, I am. I'm not going to lie. I kind of had a taste now, and I like seeing my name on the board, so I wouldn't mind to see it again.
There's, you know, a few more chefs that want to see their names on that board as well, so let's go cook some fish, shall we?
Yeah, let's do it. Go on.
To help ensure the food is flawless is guest judge Kirsty Bowen, president of a modern new wave WI group in Sheffield that embraces both the contemporary and traditional aims of the organisation.
Kirsty, welcome back to the judges' chamber.
Thank you, hello.
Kirsty joined the judges to choose Michael O'Hare as regional champion for the North East and is back today to help pick out the winning fish dish.
Have you brought an appetite?
I have, indeed, yeah.
That's a relief.
Tell us what you'd like to see at the banquet.
Our members have got a really wide range of ages. The thing that brings us all together is that we've got really high standards. So with the fish course, I'm looking for something that will really suit the variety of membership that we have, whether they prefer the traditional style of cooking or more modern raw fish, that sort of thing.
I think fish course is going to be really interesting. You know, see everyone's different take on the brief, but also it's a very technical course. You've got so little leeway to have that fish perfect. So it'll be interesting to see how everyone kind of deals with the pressure.
Last time I was here, I tried Michael's fish dish, which was really interesting. I know we all gave it really high scores, so I'm really looking forward to trying that again.
Kirsty, we used to just always choose the three best dishes, and that was the shortlist. This year, we're only choosing them if they are perfect.
And they're looking for absolute perfection as judges, so everyone's going to have to be on it to get those big tens,
yeah,
I think.
The A-game, I think.
This banquet is a journey in perfectionism.
I can't wait. Let's hope we get some really good dishes today.
The first two chefs to cook are newcomers Matt Warswick for the Northwest and Northern Ireland's Ben Arnold.
Good luck, chef.
All the best. So this year, I based my brief around my grandmother, who was in the WI for 10 years and a great influence on my sort of young cooking life. I brought a picture. There she is.
Lovely.
I've nice. Also bought here WI badge. Everybody gets a badge when they join and they enter the WI. So brought that along for sort of like a bit of a good luck.
Bit of good luck charm, yeah.
So the brief's really strong to me this year.
Funnily enough, my inspiration's also about my grandmother. She's my grandmother on her wedding day. And, you know, my story is about recipes from generation to generation. So, in essence, it's my grandmother's fish soup and turning it into a celebratory dish.
Matt and Ben have made it to the national finals on their first attempt in the competition. So, despite failing to make the shortlist yesterday, their confidence is high coming into the fish course.
I got 3.10, so there's a lot of pressure today.
That's really impressive, really good. I got 4.9.
I've really got to cook my dish as well as it did then. Otherwise, it won't be 3.10s and, you know, all the good fortune before is going to go out the window.
You don't want to let anyone down, not least your family, you know.
To find out how the chefs are getting on in the kitchen, guest judge Kirsty pays them a visit. And they're joined by Michael, who's come in to see how Matt and Ben are interpreting the brief.
Hi, Michael, nice to see you again.
Hi.
Hi.
Ben.
Ben.
Hi, Matt.
Hi, Matt, nice to meet you. So I'm Kirsty. I judged last time in the heat that Michael was in, and I gave him a 10. So I'm really looking forward to see how you guys compare, really.
Yeah, you know, my fish course was well received in the regionals, so I'm really hoping I can execute it just as well as I did in the first place.
Michael, you went quite modern with your brief.
It was quite risky, but it's the only way I know. I can't go back on tradition. I know nothing of it, so I need to do it the way I do things anyway. And it is a bit of a gamble. I'm kind of hoping it pays off.
Great. How about you?
My grandmother was a great influence on my early childhood for food, and so I based all my dishes around my grandmother, so hopefully I'll keep her proud.
WI is all about high standards, so let's just hope that your dishes really meet that perfection. So good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Matt Warswick is up first and hoping to relive his dish's success in the regionals. Grandma's pick of the day of lobster with vegetables and edible flowers is inspired by his late grandmother, a WI member who grew vegetables in her garden.
I can really see this dish at the banquet, you know, it's a bit of a treat for the women at the WI. So I'm just going to cut my socks off and try and get a great score.
Matt Warswick's grandma's pick of the day. God, it's a bit of a mouthful, but it was a beautiful mouthful to eat.
The most classic, beautifully cooked lobster tail and veg.
It's a very well-balanced dish.
I love lobster, so it'll be really, I'm really looking forward to eating it.
Matt decorates his baskets with fresh garden veg.
So are they going to eat any of this?
You can if you want. The main event is on the plate, and all the stuff around the basket is to represent what my grandmother used to grow in her garden. I got 3.10s for this one off the judges. I think he thought it was all right, so I need to get 4.10s today and maybe a 10 off the chefs as well, hopefully, if they're feeling generous.
Matt starts his vintage plates with poached lobster tails, claws and lobster sauce, baby root vegetables and garden peas, finishing with edible flowers and mint oil.
That's looking really beautiful, Matt.
Cheers, Ben.
Here's the colours.
He places his plates in his veg baskets And his fish course is ready to go.
Happy?
Yeah, I suppose I am, yeah.
Oh, don't you look lovely?
Nice one.
Looks really good.
Looks lovely. I hope it's good enough. I did all the same processes and stuff, so, but you never know what the judges are going to say, but I put everything into it. Something, eh? Getting 3 tens at the regionals is amazing. You know, trying to live up to that is hard. I think I did my grandmother proud today. Hopefully, I'm sure wherever she is, she's smiling. Me running around the kitchen, sweating. So, but it was definitely worth it.
Wow. Homegrown veg from her garden.
A member of the BLFWI. Grandma was the heart of our family.
The apple of Granddad's eye.
Oh, that's sweet.
Did you write that poem?
I did, yeah.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Very elegant looking dish. I think it's very, WI.
Oh, that lobster is exactly as I remember it. Tender as anything, full of flavour.
That lobster's perfect.
Seasoned lovely.
Nice and light as well.
I really think it's a well-balanced, really well-cooked dish.
It looks very, very simple, but there's a lot of different sensations going on.
I love the lobster and those fresh vegetables. I think it's fantastic.
I could eat that all day long.
Has he got any more?
It reminds you why a classic is a classic.
It's one of those dishes that makes you smile when you see it, and this is what the WI is all about, the gardening, the bringing things together.
I can see the scene at the banquet.
Outstanding cooking, but also outstanding ingredients as well. I think, you know, that lobster was just absolutely beautiful, and the way he's really brought out the flavours in those everyday veg, I think, is absolutely fantastic.
As usual, the chefs are scoring each other's dishes to create their own shortlist. Their scores will be averaged and added to the judges to help determine the final leaderboard.
It's a pretty perfect plate of food. You know, ticks all the boxes for me. I give it a 10.
I can't pick fault with it, and it hits the brief, so...
It's got to be a 10 for me.
3 tens.
This dish is so perfect to eat that I would give it a 9, knocking off just 1 point, because I don't think there's any modernity in it.
The dish is elegant and really suitable for the banquet. I'm giving it a 10.
I can really see it at the banquet, and I think the ladies at the WI will love that. And I score it a 10.
It's a 9 for me.
I think I'm going to have to give it a 10.
Ben Arnold is up next. After an unsuccessful start to the week, he knows his fish course must be perfect.
I really need to get in that shortlist today. Deflated after yesterday, second last. You know, I feel like this dish deserves to be up there, deserves to be in the shortlist. Prue loved the velouté last time, she's going to love it even more this time.
Like Matt, Ben's fish course is also inspired by his late grandmother. Mrs. Skillen's fish soup features a creamy velouté sauce to pour over clams, crab, brill, smoked cod and lobster.
Ben is building a really good reputation for himself in Northern Ireland. Yesterday, he did not perform nearly to the sort of level he's capable of doing. I think maybe just the pressure got to him.
I really liked this dish first time out, and I hope he's at least maintained the quality of it.
And the dish is named after his grandmother as well, Mrs. Skillen, so it'd be nice to see how that inspires what he cooks for us today.
Well, no one will be hoping more than Ben that he improves on his standing from yesterday.
So are you two both done lobster then?
Yeah.
Whoa, is it like Battle of the Crustaceans?
Battle of the Crustaceans, yeah.
Give it all that.
Although his fish course scored well with the judges, Ben wasn't so lucky when he cooked the dish first time around for veteran Phil Howard.
Regionals was not fun.
How much did you get from Phil? Points?
I got a 5. There were 2 elements missing in the regionals. I was late. The velouté was too thick, didn't go in the jars. Could barely get it out of the jars. Phil Howard stood in the past, gave me an absolute hell. And, yeah. It was a good day.
So you managed to redeem yourself in the judging chamber on the Friday?
Yeah, I did. It was a much better dish. Everything was on it. I'm really under pressure to get my name on that board. It's where I want to be all week.
Michael helps out by filling Ben's flasks with his chowder velouté sauce, while Ben starts his plates with samphire and fresh crab. Next, fillets of brill, poached lobster, clams, and smoked cod poached in milk, with sea vegetables to garnish. Finally, Michael conceals Ben's velouté sauce flasks in his special presentation box.
What's the book part?
The book is inspired by my grandmother. It's in essence my grandmother's fish soup. It was fish and water. I've tried to emulate that with a celebratory version of it. High-end fish, serve it as a soup, you know, from her recipe book. Take it away.
Well done.
Thanks.
That's great.
Is that as good as before or better?
Yeah, I think it was as good. But yeah, I'm happy with it. I believe in the story. Believe in my grandmother.
She'd be proud, Ben. Well done.
I love the book. I think the whole history, hitting the beef. Yeah. W.I. bringing the granny in. Yeah, absolutely great.
Inside the secret recipe is...
a flask, which I hope is the soup. There we go.
Got a lovely consistency, lovely colour to it.
Yeah. We have sea vegetables, we have a bit of crab meat, a bit of lobster, and this is the brill. Delicious sauce.
I think the flavour and the consistency of the velouté is perfect.
I think also that the brill has been very well cooked. I think it's firm, it's crisp, it's got a lovely sweetness to it.
Brill's lovely. Lovely dish.
It's really nice.
I'm afraid I don't think the lobster is quite as well cooked as the last dish.
Yeah, I agree. I think it's a little bit rubbery compared to Matt's dish.
The lobster's lovely, really soft, not chewy.
You don't think the quantity is a bit much?
The trouble is, it's so rich.
If you're going to have this and then follow on to a main course and then a pudding, I think I might be asleep.
I think that's a problem.
I think this one's going to be up there as well. Definitely.
I think it hits the brief. I'm going to give it a 10.
I didn't think fish would be the strongest course, but so far they seem to just be knocking them down. It's got to be a 10 for me as well.
I think I'm going to have to give this dish an 8. It's just slightly too heavy.
So it's just too big, just too rich, and just too classic, really, I think. So I should give it a... I have to say, I think it was 7.
I'd score it a 10.
It's another 10 from me.
10's all round.
Some big fish courses, huh? Big scores.
This is really good cooking. I love that velouté. Ben's fish could easily be on our shortlist.
I disagree.
So Michael's up soon. In the regional finals, you've got 4 tens.
That is the rumour. Do you know what I mean? And especially the food that he put up for the starter. Where are we going with this? I think it's going to be something to look forward to watching anyway.
How mad can he get?
The second group of chefs to cook in the kitchen are the North East's Michael O'Hare, Adam Bannister for Wales, and London and the South East's Matt Gillen.
None of us hit that shortlist yesterday.
Thanks for reminding me.
This morning, I thought we had some really beautiful dishes.
Yeah, we had some great presentation come out today.
Very beautiful.
You know, when it comes to scoring of it, I've given a 10 this morning, so it'll be interesting to see what else we've got coming up.
This is an amazing banquet for the centenary of the WI. I am still looking for that little bit of magic that is... I'm sure it's going to come.
Michael's fish course was the only one awarded 4 tens in the regionals, something his rivals know only too well.
So you're the one to beat, then?
I don't know. I've knocked out a few tens today judging other people. It's a different thing completely, I think. You know, I was confident going into it. Things have changed a little bit since I've seen the dishes that have gone out today, you know?
So the only way is down, Mike?
Adam Bannister is next with his fish course, Salmon and Cucumber, a play on afternoon tea with tea-infused salmon sandwiches and technical cucumber elements. Today, he's added a fish consomme and revised his presentation, changes he hopes will impress.
So the judges didn't feel that it was a finished dish. Some of the elements, I didn't execute them last time correctly.
at all. It was a bit of a car crash, I'd like to say. So, yeah, I sort of need to bounce back from that, you know.
So the only way is up for you, then?
Fingers crossed!
The fish course was hard for me. I really did go down, so I've got to try and forget about it, because I don't want that playing on my mind when I'm cooking today. It'd be a great honour to get onto the shortlist. You know, everybody wants to get on the shortlist.
Right, our next chef is Adam Bannister, Kirsty, and I have a rather soft spot for him. He's a young guy, has a little restaurant in Wales, but the dish we're about to eat, frankly, was not his best, was it?
It was not his finest hour. Was it a salmon dish? Was it a series of salmon sandwiches? I wasn't quite sure.
It needed work. Maybe he's done work on it. Maybe it's going to be fine.
Well, it sounds really interesting dish, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what he does with the salmon.
Stop shaking would be a good thing.
Adam starts his oversized glass teacups with charred cucumber and tea-brined salmon. Rolls of compressed pickled cucumber and crispy salmon skin.
Someone pour the consommé into there, please. Jack, in the glass chiller, there's cucumber jellies. Can you equip them, please?
Okay. Next, fried sandwich parcels filled with salmon and cucumber jelly go onto the cake stand. Followed by compressed cucumber slices filled with more cucumber jelly. But there's a problem.
What's happened with your jelly, man?
It's just a bit too hot by here. I'm not 100% happy, so I'm not serving it.
Having decided not to serve the melting cucumber elements, Adam presents his dish alongside teapots filled with fish consommé.
Well done.
Cheers, thank you.
Dad, it's over.
That's the one I was nightmares about it. And so the jelly's really refreshing, isn't it? But I don't want to send it, because...
Are you better off not serving it?
Yeah,
serving
something like it.
You know, sitting there going, oh, God, what
did I
say?
It's running on the plate.
And that's what would have happened.
Yeah. You know, I gave it everything I could. Just hope the judges like the changes I made.
This is a bit of a change.
Oh, this is 100% improvement on last time.
Looks lovely.
Agreed.
Very pretty. Consommé in there. Oops.
Yeah. I think this is wonderful.
Well, this presumably is fish consommé.
It smells really nice.
So the consommé is super clear.
Yeah,
you'd be happy with that.
Like the pickle on the cucumber.
That's nice.
Very refreshing.
Bit of charred cucumber, some salmon, little cucumber rolls. These look like wraps, but in fact, what they've done is bread, which has been squeezed in a pasta machine.
The ingredients are the same as last time, and this time it's delicious because it's crisp on the outside, not soggy.
I really like the sandwich. The way that you can pick it up and it's quite dainty, I think it's really got loads of flavour, because that tea really comes through, and I think it really packs a punch.
I really love it. I think from once the consommé goes into the cup, and it sets off this sort of series of flavours which infuses it, it's great.
I like the pickled cucumber.
I wasn't expecting it, like, to be so zingy. Added another dimension to the dish.
The cucumber jelly doesn't has no particular significance.
I actually don't get jelly from it, which might mean that it wasn't really worth doing.
It's supposed to be cucumber jelly.
Yeah.
I think the jelly's a bit grainy. I would leave the jelly off, and you're looking at a great, great score.
I think with a few little tweaks, it could be a 10, but at the moment, it's a 9 for me.
There's just a couple of things that weren't quite right on there. I'm going to give this dish an 8.
I'll give it an 8 too, given that it's not as memorable as the food that I've had today.
It is a 9.
There's elements on it that I think are strong, but I'm going to have to give that a 7.
I think it's delicious, absolutely delicious.
Well, I mean, do we have another shortlist contender here?
We all love it, and I think it's a 9.
Michelin-starred Matt Gillen is up next. It's his second time in the competition, but first time in the finals. He missed out on the starter shortlist yesterday, so today he's taking a risk he hopes will put him in contention for the banquet.
A brand new dish is a bit of a gamble, and it can pay off, or it can go the other way. But I think it's a better dish than I had in regionals, and, you know, I'm fairly confident going into fish course.
Matt's dish, Jamming and Canning, celebrates the WI's support for preserving food over their 100-year history. In a change from the regionals, he swapped salmon for sardines, chicken wings and langoustine. He's serving them with cans of sardine tartare and langoustine bisque, sardines in toast and rhubarb compote.
It's my first incarnation of this dish, totally bombed.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, with the judges or with the veterans?
Yeah, with the judges, with, well, both, to be honest. I took the theme of the jam too far and it's just a little bit sweet, look at odds on the dish. But it's too important to lose from my menu, so I just reworked the dish and I think I've got a much better dish now, so.
You got a few changes on it then?
A few changes, yeah. the whole thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the whole thing's changed.
Matt Gillen, next one up. He's the chef who has taken the history of the WI right through all his courses. And his fish course was not a success. This food arrived on a salt block, and there was a variety of really unattractive lumps of food on the salt block, and none of us liked it, and we told him to can it.
It quite simply wasn't good enough.
To win over the judges with his new fish course, Matt must execute each element to perfection. He colours his langoustine and finishes them in langoustine stock glaze. He starts his plates with rhubarb compote, sautéed baby gem, and oyster sauce glazed chicken wings.
It's a bit of pressure. Maybe a bit off more than I can chew, but if I don't push myself in the finals, when I cannot push myself.
Next, langoustine and pan-fried sardines. And the dish is covered with a jam jar-style cloche. Finally, Matt places his sardine tartare on spoons in special serving tins, tops with his deep-fried sardines in toast, and pours langoustine bisque into cans.
Great chef.
That looks great.
Thanks very much. I'm glad that's done. It's quite a push, actually.
That looked great.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So if it eats just as well.
He's definitely tweaked this dish.
Just a bit.
This is a completely different dish.
It's just such fun.
That's delicious.
The sauce isn't too strong, and I think the whole thing is a great plate of food and a really tasty plate of food to eat.
Can you actually overdose on bisque? I think I'm going to...
The rhubarb is really good, really sharp, and I think that works super well with the oily fish.
Just a wee kick at the end.
I really like that.
Now, what is that?
I don't know if it's pastry or bread around the outside, but the fish inside has made it go really soggy for me.
The least tasty part for me is the toast.
The toast element, the one that I tasted, wasn't particularly crisp at all.
I've never had the sardine tartare before. It's absolutely delicious.
Good. Tartare's nice.
The tartare is okay, but I just don't see how it fits in with this other little plate.
I don't think it needs the chicken wing.
No. Quite sure why it's there.
Matt's a talented guy. Doesn't need to show all of his skills in one dish.
He's just trying too hard.
There's just too many things on the plate and they're not necessarily coming together successfully.
I just think it's overworked. I think maybe less is more. I would score this dish a 7.
I'm going to score this dish a 7 as well. Virtually everything on there was cooked perfectly, but there's two separate dishes there.
I love the brain work behind it, and I'd give him an 8, actually, for that.
I mean, I think it's an 8 because it's brilliant cooking.
I'm going to go a 9.
I loved everything about it. You know, I've got to give it a 10.
I think it's a case of too many things and he's lost the direction.
The next chef to cook is Michael O'Hare. Despite making the chef's top 3 for his starter, the judges' scores dragged him all the way down to last place. But he's optimistic today.
Feeling quite confident going into fish. 4 tenths from the judges last time. I think the fish course is one of my strongest chances of getting a dish at the banquet. It's a strong message and it's a unique dish.
Michael's fish course is his signature artistic interpretation of fish and chips.
I wanted to dedicate it to women's rights and equality. The dish is called Emancipation, which translated from Latin just means to take out the hand.
Featuring a ceramic hand, which for Michael represents women's emancipation, the dish includes cod loin, crispy potatoes, and a squid ink and vinegar powder, inspired by his dark industrial hometown near Redcar Beach.
This is a really exciting dish. It ticks all the boxes.
And you know what? It's making me really nervous, because if you remember when the four of us sat here and ate this dish before, and Kirsty was with us, we gave it a 10, 10, 10, 10. Mm. And that's a fantastic ask, to expect him to do it again just like that.
Let's hope it's just as good.
Let's hope it is.
OK, now, just let someone at this table have their feet on the ground for just one second. This is a very, very high-risk dish, and if it simply doesn't deliver on the cooking front, on the flavour front, then it's going to be an unmitigated catastrophe.
Yeah. With the expectation on my shoulders from the other chefs, also the judges, to deliver what I delivered again, quite a strange feeling. I had confidence in my dish at the start, but it's up against some really strong dishes, and I really don't know how this is going to go.
Michael prepares his canvas serving platters by spraying with his cod dashi sauce, which has been decanted into spray cans.
Hearing that Michael got 4 10s in the regionals, I think it's pretty worrying.
I think the dish is a bit too safe.
It's certainly a little conservative.
To the ceramic hands, he adds scorched baby gem, topping with shredded potatoes and sous vide cooked cod loin.
Do you think you pushed yourself enough for this? Have you got any risks?
Michael adds crispy potatoes and squid ink and vinegar powder to represent the dark industrial side of his hometown.
Never seen anything like that.
No. Next, he splashes his canvas with cod dashi sauce.
Michael, I've heard you got quite a high score for that. I got 4 10s from the judges.
That's epic.
And finally, forced shoot sprayed with edible silver and gold paint.
I literally feel like I'm watching something original and different and amazing. I'm literally stunned.
Can I get a hand to take these up to the pack?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Well, does that deserve a round of applause?
Don't shake your hand, mate.
I'll give you another one.
Well done.
Cheers, man.
That's all I can say.
It's the most different fish and chips, I'll give them that.
Well, it looks the same.
So far, so good.
You've never seen anything like it. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say.
What's in the envelope?
The picture of Michael and his grandma on Redcar Beach.
So I guess we need to find out, don't we?
Let's see if it's as good as it looks.
Tastes as good as it looks.
I'm still not quite sure with this dish whether I should actually put it up on the wall or whether I should eat it.
Let's get straight in there.
This cod is absolutely delicious. The thing I love about cod is when it's flaky, and, you know, he's made the flakiness to perfection here.
The potatoes, little potatoes, are formed into divine wodges. There has that fat and potato and sweetness to it.
I think the cod's cooked perfectly.
Everything on there delivers, I think, and I think that you still taste fish and chips.
I think the saucing is really good. It's really interesting. You know, squid ink, dashi.
Squid ink has that sort of tremendous marine flavour called dashi. And the whole point about dashi is to sort of bring out that meaty note that you get from really good fish.
As much as it looked like an artist's work on presentation, it's still a really great plate of food. Pretty special.
It is so difficult to be different in food, and I think he's really pulled it off.
Oh, look, I think this is wonderful.
I would love to see the look on all the WI's faces, because if it's anything as speechless as you guys around the table there, I think that would just be
a night to remember.
It is shocking. It has got that shock factor, but it tastes fantastic. I think it tells a story, and I do think our members will get it. Michael is really challenging stereotypes and trying to make us remember the roots of the WI, campaigning for women's equal rights, and it's fantastic to see this smack bang on the plate in front of you.
It's absolutely delicious. Everything's cut perfectly. Can't fault it.
He's literally a genius.
So 10 for me.
10 for me.
I can't do this. Let's give this 10.
I'm there. I think it's a 10.
10 for me.
10 for me.
It's smart, it's clever, it's different. I would be so happy to see this on the shortlist.
The last group cooking today are the two chefs on the starter shortlist, Central Region's Richard Bainbridge and the Southwest's Josh Eggleton, along with Scotland's Jack O'Donnell, who just missed out.
Let's do it.
So here I am in the kitchen with the two shortlisters today.
Well, you weren't far off there, were you?
First up, one of the youngest Michelin-starred chefs in the UK. Josh Eggleton cooked for the judges last year, but didn't make it to the finals. He started this week on a high with a brand new dish making the starter shortlist.
Didn't think I was going to get very far on my starter because it was a risk. I changed my dish. So to get it straight up there on the shortlist, it was fantastic. I think you ought to come in every day with the aim of getting on the shortlist. It's as simple as that.
Josh's whole menu has been inspired by the women in his life and the campaigns and causes of the WI. His fish dish is cod with chicken and mushroom sauce, confit chicken wings, ham hock, and crispy chicken skin. The dish is called the Agricultural Pie Scheme, inspired by the WI's wartime distribution of their homemade pies. But it's a name that caused some confusion in the regionals.
Is there pastry on it? Is it a pie?
No, there's no pie. It's not a pie, but it's a sauce, it's in the name. So it's sort of the garnish of a chicken and mushroom pie, you know? I don't know why people struggle with it so much.
I think the problem with Josh's dish was the title. It makes you think it was a pie, when actually, in fact, it wasn't a pie. What it was cod with the chicken sauce.
When someone says pie, you want a pastry topping, don't you, so...
Call me old-fashioned.
Or at least some sort of crust or crumble or something on top. He wanted to hark back to the WI's Agricultural Pie Scheme, and I don't think he has to do all that much tweaking to make it really excellent. I mean, I think I gave it an 8 because I love the flavour of the filling.
And I did get criticised in the heat for not having real pastry. So I've listened to the judges. I put a bit of pastry on, yeah. You know, I've had a bit of choux pastry, so it was only a minor change. I like this dish. It kind of represents the way I cook, you know? So I'm quite happy with it.
Josh starts his plate with confit chicken wings, followed by mushroom puree, mushrooms, pan-roasted cod, and smoked ham hock.
How are we getting on?
I'm not finished yet, so I'll let you know afterwards.
Next, he pipes mushroom puree into his choux pastry gougère, a new addition he hopes will win the judges over.
So that's your pastry element?
It's definitely pastry. Just might not be the pastry that they're looking for.
Josh adds tarragon leaves, crispy chicken skin, and chicken sauce.
Is that a chicken pie or a fish pie?
Finally, he tops his plates with faux pastry pie lids.
Good effort, look really lovely.
Is it a pie or not?
Wow.
Just because I got it right with the starter doesn't mean I'm gonna get it right with the fish course, so, you know, it could all go wrong today.
I thought it was going to be real pastry. You know, this is just what he had last time, which was inedible lid.
Yeah, but there is a little sort of choux pastry bun on the inside. So I think that's stretching the notion of a pie a bit far.
I'm surprised that he hasn't tried to change the dish more.
It was pastry that he felt he had to put in, but I don't think the dish needed it.
No.
Beautifully cooked cod.
You're surrounded by meats, which are very highly flavoured.
The fish is nice, it's not blowing me away. I think the chicken and the mushrooms are better on the plate.
The best flavours are not the cod.
When you take the lid off, I didn't expect that plate of food.
Yeah.
I think it's very heavy, orientated on meat.
It's quite meaty, and I don't know if that pie sauce tastes so much like pie as much as it does a chicken kind of gravy. Yeah.
I actually think it's delicious, but it isn't particularly wonderful to look at, except that it looks fun when it comes up, and then it's a disappointment because you can't eat the pastry.
The presentation's really subtle and clever.
So WI. They like a bit of humour and trickery, so I think they'll get a good laugh.
The great thing about that pie scheme was that they'd be given to people, you know, working really hard, and they'd have a really satisfying meal. For me, I just don't get that satisfaction from this dish.
Well, all the parts are well executed, but it is just absolutely rudderless as a dish.
I agree.
I think as a pie, it's half baked.
It ticks all the boxes, has the brief, and I score an 8.
I'm going to go 9.
I'm going 9.
It's a little bit heavy on the meat for me. I'm going to score it an 8.
How many marks are you going to give it?
Certainly not in excess of 6.
It's not what I'd want to see at the banquet.
This is just pie in the sky, isn't it? This is going nowhere.
So what'd you give me?
I gave it a 9. It was up there for
really?
Me.
Thank you.
Yeah, 9 from me too.
Really?
Yeah.
Thank you very
I
much.
I
loved it.
So, Rich, have I got you worried then?
Got me worried, but mine's a completely different dish, so I don't even know how it's all going to plan out. But mind you, yours was a new dish yesterday, so that filled me with a little bit of confidence.
Richard Bainbridge is up next. This year, on his 4th attempt, he was finally crowned Central Region Champion and is determined to cook at the banquet. He's already in the running with his starter.
Getting my starter on the shortlist was amazing, epic. And to be on such a journey with a Great British Menu, I feel as though this could actually be my year. But the pressure never gets easy in that kitchen, and these guys are cooking at the top of their game. You've got to keep pushing.
But after serving an oversmoked and overcooked trout dish to the judges in the regionals, Richard has completely changed his fish course to Mama Bainbridge's fish pie, a dish dedicated to his mum.
So that's my mum.
Yeah.
That's her WI look.
So she's a WI?
Of course she is.
Oh,
she joined it especially for me. That's
right.
So when I was growing up, she used to make fish pies and cottage pies and things like that. So it kind of came to me that why don't I do a little nod to my mum?
I think there might be tears.
What, with me or her?
Probably both.
Like Josh, Richard's gone for a modern twist on a traditional pie. But his features seafood in a champagne sauce.
Kirsty, next up is Rich Bainbridge. Yesterday, he got into the shortlist for the starters.
What Rich is a testament to trying, because it's his 4th time in the competition. He has kept coming back, and he's delivered.
Well, he better deliver a bit better on his fish course, because we so hated his smoked trout in plum flavour. And
it was an unmitigated disaster.
Totally changing the dish. Is that not a bit of a risk?
Well, up until coming into the kitchen yesterday, I thought that was a risk, and I was quite nervous about it. But after Josh paving the way, maybe changing the dish at the last minute is the way forward.
Richard starts his pie bowls with parsley oil, followed by a base of potato mousse and garlic-infused spinach.
Bring it all together now, yeah?
Yeah, slowly but surely now coming together.
He adds his brown shrimps and champagne sauce. Next, smoked haddock cooked sous vide in milk, pollock, salmon, and charred sea bass with a garnish of deep-fried shallot rings. Finally, Richard serves his fish pies on special WI boards covered with fishing baskets.
Hopefully I would have done a proud on that one. But my mum's got high standards. She's in the WI after all, so we'll have to wait and see. If I mess it up, she's not going to be in the best of moods.
Oh. Oh, this is fish pie, is it? Once again, it's a reinterpretation of the word pie, isn't it?
We've got mash, though he calls it mousse, and it's green because of the herb oil.
Is it a fish pie?
It's a fish pie,
That looks suspiciously like a bit of salmon to me.
I love brown shrimp.
I still wrestle with this notion of a pie that has no top,
and indeed has a sort of goo of potato around the bottom, and which is sweet.
I think I'm going to have to agree with you there. The texture is quite gloopy, and that champagne's giving it real sweetness, and I don't really like it.
I really like how all the fish is cooked separately.
Mm. And everyone's perfect.
I think it's delicious. I think everything on it's cooked nicely.
Nice flavour, isn't it?
The only thing I would say, I don't think it's anything new.
I think it's a very strong dish.
I think there are issues around the mash, but I think this is good. I can easily eat this.
Well, as long as you like eating lumps of tasteless fish in a glue, then I'm sure it's an absolutely admirable dish in every way.
What would you give it?
I'll give this dish an 8.
I'll give it an 8 as well.
I would give it 6.5 or 7.
I don't really like it. I'd probably give it a 5.
Oof. That is harsh.
I'm sorry.
I'm just going to mark him down by 1 point and give him a 9. And just say for me, it doesn't blow me away.
I'll give it a 10.
I'm going to give it a 9.
Hi, Max.
Yeah.
Again. It's worrying. Are you happy with the dish that you produced today, Richard?
I am, but I know you guys have put up better dishes than me, and I'm big enough to say that.
I gave you a 10. I thought it was a strong dish. I thought it hit the brief, so I don't think you're out of the running just yet, yeah?
Last chef to cook is Scottish champion Jack O'Donnell, the only chef in the kitchen who's completed finals week before. Last year it was a complete disaster. She didn't make it onto the judges or the chef's shortlist once.
It's a really different competition for me this year. Last year I was really deflated. Yesterday I got shortlisted with the chefs. I came third with the judges. That's brilliant. My fish is my strong dish and this is my chance to get on the judges' shortlist to be thought of for the banquet. So I'm up against it today.
Jack's dish is her interpretation of the classic dressed salmon with a grapefruit and lemon chutney. It was her strongest dish in the regionals.
So, Jack, do you know what the judges gave you in the chamber?
I got 2 tens in the chamber for this one.
Oh, right, brilliant.
2 tens. This dish was a triumph. I gave it a 10.
I think Jack is a person who cooks from the heart, and when that works, it really works.
It was a beautifully worked variation on a WI tradition, I think it is, to have a whole poached salmon as a sort of centrepiece of a feast.
At RWI, we don't have many centrepiece dishes like that, but I understand the reference to that kind of traditional party food.
And I do think this dish is her big chance.
My fish course is my take on dressed salmon.
You're doing, like, a big one.
Changed it from a centrepiece to an individual dressed salmon for the ladies, because this is a special day.
So it sounds like a lot of work, that.
It is a lot of work. Stop talking to me. Got so many cucumbers to slice.
I'm actually feeling really nervous, because I feel as though this is my shout at getting to the banquet. This is one of my strongest dishes, and this is what I've got. So I hope it's good enough.
I want to make sure that this is absolute perfection today.
You want to get up there, yeah?
Yep, sure do.
Jack fills her vintage-style silver pots with her lemon and grapefruit chutney and places them on her plates with portions of salmon dressed with cucumber scales and pickled beetroot cubes.
Need anything, Jack?
Gin and tonic would be lovely.
She finishes her dish with dots of dill mayonnaise and beetroot crisps. The presentation is finally complete with fish kettles.
Well, Jack, you're going all out. Right?
That's all I've got. I'm not coming in tomorrow.
Morning.
Oh, ooh. It is so pretty.
It is pretty.
Lovely colours.
Presentation spot on. Get the connection straight away. Dressed salmon.
Poached salmon is cooked really, really nicely.
Just cooked.
The chutney works really well with the fish.
I know, one would never think that citrus chutney.
No.
It's almost like marmalade, actually. Mm.
Try the relish.
Whoa.
The relish is real bitter.
It tastes like all my least favourite things about marmalade, that chutney.
And that bright yellow stuff is actually a mayo, isn't it?
Mm, it's dill mayo. Quite a marked flavour of dill, actually. Mm.
The dill's really delicious, but I think it could be a bit more dill.
Mm. I think Jack has fulfilled the brief really well.
And it tastes fantastic. It's really, really nice. The salmon's got a lovely texture to it.
It is such precise cooking. I mean, every one of those tiny things is perfect, isn't it?
I think all the individual elements work well together, but for me, it's not a fish course. I'd see this more as a starter.
All the flavours work beautifully together.
She hasn't slipped up anywhere.
I can't see anybody having a problem with it. You know, it's traditional, but the way it looks, it feels very modern. I think everyone would love it.
It tastes great, but there's just something that is missing to make me go, that's amazing.
As much as cooked really nicely, it's slightly underwhelming.
Really satisfying dish. I think it's got to be a 10.
It's got to be a 10.
Not a banquet dish, not with the level of the food that's been up already. I'll give it a 5.
I'm going to give this dish a 7.
I'd score this dish a 7 as well.
I think it's beautiful, so I really do think it's a 10.
We've had some phenomenal dishes today. The number of 9s and 10s that we scattered around with such gay abandon.
We might have to have a long or short list now.
We've got this contrast between modern cooking and classical cooking, and I've given dishes at both ends of the spectrum 10s.
I think that what would be wonderful if at the end of the banquet we have a mixture of these styles.
It's the menu that defines the banquet.
I really am very, very interested to see the chef's scores today.
Oh, my goodness, they better agree with us, because I feel so strongly we are right.
Before the final leaderboard is revealed, it's time to find out from the chef's scores alone who is on their shortlist.
On the chef's shortlist, there's 3 dishes. I think I speak for everyone that there's no surprise that, Michael, one of them. Thank you. Congratulations.
Excellent.
Happy days.
Matt Warswick.
Thank you very much.
Peace and love is breaking out.
They agree with us so far.
And Ben. Well done, guys. Well deserved.
His fish soup
was delicious, but I don't think that's as good as dish as Jack's.
They rated her highly yesterday, and what has she done today to deserve this?
It was my best shot at getting on the shortlist.
To be honest, I'm ecstatic that the chefs thought my dish was good enough to be in the top 3.
Hello, chefs. I'm very happy to say that we have seen and eaten some absolutely spectacular food today, which I thank you. As you know, only perfect dishes can go through to the shortlist. I can see no reason for prolonging the agony any longer. In 8th place, it's Rich. Triumph yesterday. Today, I'm afraid neither we nor your fellow chefs thought that highly of your fish dish.
I know. It was a change from my previous one that I gave you last time. And my idea was really that I wanted to just give you a good plate of food that hopefully you would enjoy.
It didn't quite come off.
No.
Anyway,
thank you very much. Thanks for trying it anyway.
Thank you. In 7th place, it's Josh. I've had top of the leaderboard yesterday as well, but I'm afraid not so high today. We did think actually it was some very, very good cooking, but in the final analysis, what is a pie without a pastry top?
I tried to add a little bit of pastry for you, but obviously
not quite enough.
All changes.
Big guns.
Oh, dear.
In 6th place,
Prince.
Matt Killen. Now, that was actually a very fine new dish, Matt, and a very brave one, if I might say so. But there were just too many elements that didn't quite work for us.
Thank you very much.
In fifth place, it's Ben. Now, Ben, your fellow chefs thought very, very highly of your dish, but we felt it was just a bit too rich and too large for the banquet.
No worries. Thank you for the feedback.
Oh!
What's that all about?
I can't believe that.
Mate.
Oh, well.
It's down to the last four. And in fourth place, it's Adam. Adam, that dish was a vast improvement on its previous incarnation. It was witty, it was elegant, and it fell short by the tiniest margin. So congratulations.
I'm glad that the improvements did make improvements. Thank you.
Fantastic improvement.
So, three of you left. Well, we could scarcely have had more contrasting and different interpretations of the brief than the three dishes that you served up. And that really poses us with a huge problem. We debated long and hard, and in the end, we decided that all three of you had to be on the shortlist. Jack, you look absolutely staggered.
My foot's been going off this bar since number 8.
Well, how do you feel?
I can't believe that I've been put in the top three with what these guys produced today. I'm absolutely honoured that you think so.
Jack, your salmon dish was absolutely beautiful. It had the tradition of the WI through and through. It was delicate, it was pretty. It was truly wonderful.
Thank you so much.
Matt.
Absolutely over the moon.
Well, I must say, I thought your lobster dish was wonderfully refined and it was simply a joy to eat. Well, Michael.
Yeah, really happy to be in the shortlist given my poor result yesterday. So thank you all for that.
What can I say? Your fish dish was absolutely extraordinary. It was a completely original take on the brief. Great dish.
Thank you.
I've had a phenomenal day. Thank you. Perfect dishes, perfect cooking. Whoever wins is going to be an amazing banquet. Thank you. Well done. From yesterday on the chef's shortlist to today on judges' shortlist, I've done so well.
I was genuinely moved by Jack's reaction. She just did not think she was going to get through.
I'm really disappointed. You can't take for granted being shortlisted by the chefs that you're going to be shortlisted by the judges, but, you know, I did.
I'm not best pleased. You just don't want your name to be called out first, especially when you've gone from the heights of being called last. Takes you back down to earth. It's a nice feeling to be shortlisted from a fish course.
Yeah, Michael's got star written all over him, doesn't he? He's not arrogant, but he's very confident in what he does.
What happened?
We've all got shortlisted to possibly go to the banquet.
Well done.
Well done.
All of my family and my grandmother would be absolutely made up. They'd be, you know, they're behind me 100%, and wherever my grandmother is, I'm sure she is as well.